Shalom to everybody and Chag Sameach. It's a big privilege and a zchut to be part of your Aseret Adibot program. I was thinking to myself, this is how we should do it in shul. We should have 10 different people read out each one of the commandments. Should actually have every man and woman present in shul come up and read something. Just like it was in Har Sinai when we received the Torah. There was one voice there, but hundreds of thousands of people that each heard their own personal Torah. So we're advancing a step towards that. So I received number 9, Lo ta'aneh bere'acha et shakir, don't tell a lie. When we were growing up, our parents always told us, tell the truth and don't lie, just like we tell our children. And when you want to emphasize how important it is, then you tell them it's even in Aseret Adibot. It says in the 10 commandments that you shouldn't lie. The truth is that's not true. It never says that in Aseret Adibot. It says, Lo ta'aneh bere'acha et shakir, just like it doesn't say not to steal. Because Lo tignov was about stealing a soul, not stealing something. Lo ta'aneh bere'acha et shakir is about not bearing false witness. And if we look in the book of Dvarim, it says, Lo ta'aneh bere'acha et shav. Shav is something futile. Our witness should have some meaning. And there's a big difference between telling the truth or not lying and between bearing witness. Because we bear witness to the people around us, to the people we love, to our family and friends all the time. And being a witness is much more than sticking to the truth. Our most important witnesses in our lives are the ones we bring to our chupa. And they're standing there not to say what happened. In many ways, they're there to say what can happen and what can be. Many times, they're close friends and people that grew up with us. And they're there not to be witnesses to what's happening in the chuppah, but to what they hope and we hope can happen with our lives. So being witnesses, being edim, is much more than sticking to the truth. It's telling a much greater truth about what can be in this world. And maybe just to emphasize this point, I want to bring a very interesting halakha and a discussion from many years ago, something from the Shulchan Aruch and two commentators who relate to that. So the halakha I want to bring is actually a sad one. It's about a hesped, a eulogy. And the Shulchan Aruch, Rabbi Yosef Karo from the 16th century, says in Siman Shin Mem Hei, says the following. When you give a eulogy, there's different laws. So he says, Mitzvah gdola lehaspid al amet kara'uy. Ve'asur lehaflik b'shivcho yoter midai. Ela mazkirim midot tovot shebo. U'mosifim bahem k'tzat, rak shelo yaflik. I'll translate. He says, when we're giving a eulogy, it's a great mitzvah that we say all the good things that we can say. We're supposed to say all the wonderful things we know about the deceased. And we're even supposed to add a bit. In his words, "Mosifim v'em k'tzat, rak shelo yaflig." You can say a bit more. Just don't over-exaggerate. And ever since I read this halakha, I've been very interested. Because the Shulchan Aruch is actually telling us to lie. Just a bit, but telling us to lie. And one of the commentators, the Taz, the Turei Zahav, from Krakow in the 17th century, says, Mali sheker muat, mali sheker merube. If you're lying, says the Taz, it doesn't matter if it's a big lie or a small lie, it's still a lie. And there's two answers that the commentators there bring. I want to share both with you. One says that the problem is that we never really tell the truth about other people. Because when somebody's alive, we never want to say the full truth. Because if she was a wonderful person, I don't want to say that. Because where does that put me? Or if he did so many amazing things, it's not something that I want to tell, because I don't do so many amazing things. So when somebody is deceased, we can add a bit to what we usually say, because it's not a lie, it's just the real truth that we're never saying, because we're in kind of a competition. And that competition ends when they're not here anymore. The other answer, which I like even better, is that every one of us is a bit more than what we think. The Taz says that when we do good deeds in this world, if somebody pushed us a bit more, we would probably do just a bit more. And we're always willing to stretch ourselves a bit more than what we're used to. So basically, if we're lying a bit, and if we're adding to the person, when we're giving a eulogy, we're not telling the truth. We're telling the full truth. And if I go back to telling the truth and bearing witness, if being a witness is saying what the person can be, and telling the truth is what we are, so we prefer to bear witness. We prefer to tell the full truth about the person and say what they can do in this world. So if I go back to the Ten Commandments deal with the core of our existence. And they want to say something more than just telling the truth in this world. It's important. When our parents told us when we were little kids not to lie, they said something true. It's very important to tell the truth. But when we walk around today and in every day with the people we love, with our family and friends, the words "lo taneh b'reacha ed shaker" or "lo taneh b'reacha ed shav" are calling us to a bit more than just telling the truth. They're calling us to look at every person, every man or woman that we meet, and tell them the full truth about themselves. Tell them who they are, but better yet, tell them who they can be and what they can make of themselves. Those are the witnesses that we're called upon to be on this Chag Shavuot. So I want to thank you again for the pleasure. I've been thinking of you and of everybody overseas over these past few weeks and months. And thank you for the opportunity to bridge the gap and to close the distance. And I call on all of us to be great witnesses to the era, to the time, and to the people around us, and to make the best of what can be. And I want to wish you and us and all of Am Yisrael and all the people of this world, Chag Sameach.